Nacht! Are you okay?
No. Where's Arden?
Wait. He's here? If he is, that would explain all this weird stuff happening. I bet he's behind the train stopping. Ignis and Gladio went up to inspect the engine room. I say the two of us go check out the rear.
Yeah.
We have to protect the people! Head to the next car!
Leave these guys to us!
So much for a safe ride. More of them might be on board. Let's check the rear.
We need to get the train moving again.
I'm sure Ignis and Gladio will come up with something.
I hope so. Let's go.
Ah! Crap! The MTs can self-destruct!
Can't let them inside.
Well then, we take the fight to them. Things use! Ah! We've got company!
Sure do.
Let the party begin! Ah! Guys look like trouble.
Dead meat!
Looks like they've rolled out the big guns.
Pronto. Stay.
He's back on his feet.
What's wrong?
Ignis, you've got to stop this thing. Pronto fell off the train. I pushed him. I mean, Arden made me. I don't know where he is, but we can't leave him.
Stay calm, Nacht. I'm as concerned for Pronto as you are. But stopping the train would endanger everyone on board. We'd be sitting ducks for the demons.
What do we do?
First, we drop the passengers off at Tenebrae. We'll be arriving shortly.
What about Pronto?
Given the Chancellor's involvement, it's probable he's no longer where we left him. In any case, he may try to contact us. Let us wait and hope for now. Can you make your way here? Gladio's with me.
Are the two of you okay at least?
Yes.
Okay, on my way. What in the world?
Thank you.
Well, look who's here.
Haranea. Guess we've got you to thank for this mess.
More to it than meets the eye. You want to know who to thank? Come with me.
Can't wait to hear this.
Huh? What did you do to your eyes?
Just a flesh wound.
Can you see?
I'm afraid not.
Wow, that sucks. It's a cruel world. Wasn't there one more of you guys?
Yeah, there was.
We lost track of him.
Is he dead?
I don't know.
Then quit moping, keep hoping. And in the meantime, handle what's at hand.
So if it's not you, we thank.
Oh, thank the demons. Pawns of the Imperial Army.
The army that you fight for.
Fought for. My men and I are in the search and rescue business now.
You mentioned being part of the relief effort. We have a favor to ask.
Ask away.
In light of what you've told us, we can't allow the other passengers to continue on.
Sure, leave them to me. But who's gonna drive the train?
Now that you mention it, yeah. You know anyone?
I do. In fact, I know two. Your new engineers. Biggs and Wedge. No need to worry. They can take a licking.
Only if we have to. What's all this about?
Driving a train to Gralia.
That all?
Well, who would you have me ask?
You got us there.
We'll do it. Hey, really appreciate you going out of your way.
Yeah. No sweat.
Hey, thanks for the lift.
We're happy to help. Can't say the climate will be as cooperative, though. You know?
Right. Especially the gorge.
The place is freezing. Makes sense what with the Ice Goddess's cold corpse lying around. It's a rather long ride, so I suggest you bundle up before we ship out. By the way, I bumped into a woman from the manor. Used to serve House Florey. Must have gone off looking for you. Said she had something important to discuss.
With me? Guess I ought to find her then.
We'll be waiting on board. Give us a holler when you're ready to shovel.
My word. Is that you, Prince Noctis?
Yeah. Have we...
Oh, blessed be the stars. Just look at what a fine young man you've grown into. I am Maria, a retainer in service to House Florey. I doubt you'll remember me after these long years.
I can't say I do.
Don't worry. Who I am is of little import in light of what I wish to discuss. Lady Lunafreya risked everything to spirit the Ring of the Lucii away from the Citadel. Did she deliver it to you?
Yeah.
Stars above! My fears have been assuaged. Lord Ravis II will be overjoyed to hear this news.
Ravis II?
To fail me.
No, I cannot accept it. By your hand, it must be done. To deliver the ring and inspire the king is your calling. You mustn't fall.
But I lack the strength to go on.
Find it, Lunafreya. You have the will. Go to Noctis. Show him the truth of your heart.
I understand you will go hence to the Imperial capital.
Yeah.
Lord Ravis has King Regis's glaive in his safekeeping, and it was his wish to return it to you, my prince. Though I imagine it will not be easy for you to find each other.
I'll get it from him somehow.
I pray it shall be so.
Prince Noctis!
Yeah?
Prince Noctis, were you excited to marry Lady Lunafreya? Because she was really excited to marry you. She looked so happy the day her dress arrived. She really loved you, Prince Noctis.
I... Thank you.
At first, the father had mourned the fate of his chosen son. Yet in Tenebrae, the two found solace. It was not the Oracle who assuaged their fears. But the girl, she holds the true power.
I have little to offer a king, other than the voice afforded the Oracle. Nevertheless... And... I'm afraid you might find this foolish. But to be together with Noctis again, even if only for a short while, it would mean the world to me. I do not seek to guide him, merely to stand beside him.
She was burdening you with the wedding. That's not true, is it?
No, not at all.
Will we ever see the dawn? What has become of our world?
How in the world could something like this happen?
Perhaps this is the way it ends.
Ready to depart. Just swapped out the damaged cars for some new ones. Give one of us a holler when you're ready to shove off, then.
Dining car's open, if you need a break.
Don't worry about the civilians. They're in my good hands. Can't say the same for you. Watch yourselves in the capital.
We will.
Thanks, Aranea. We'll see you around. It's... snowing.
Get your ass on board!
Yes, sir.
Oi! And attention all passengers! We're on our way to our final destination in the Imperial Capital! Enjoy the ride! I'll be in touch if anything comes up.
Look at all that snow. No wonder it's so cold in here.
We must be approaching the Glacian's cadaver.
Won't be a blessing if all we got's a body.
Let us hope we pass through the gorge without incident.
It's what's after the gorge I'm worried about. wonder what it could be this time.
Attention, Adam.
Yeah?
What's wrong?
You may have noticed we stopped. As for the cause, outside, you think?
We'll take a look.
Oh, Adam.
I hope it's just a quick snow shoveling job.
Indeed.
Hey, knocked!
What's up?
You better get in here. Something's
Got
not
it.
Right.
Come on,
Iggy.
There
in a sec.
Right.
No way. You! Hold it! Oh, that son of a bitch. What the hell?
Stop! Stop, damn it! Where is he? Where's Prompto?
Oh, there you are. I'm worried about your friends. They've fallen and they can't get up. Why not lend them a hand? A coldness that can only be hers.
Let it now be done, as promised to the Oracle.
Tiana, it's you. You're the Glacian. What?
O King of Kings. Restore light unto the world.
Sister, cease this madness. That boy will never be king.
Noctis is chosen. It is ordained. You of all people should know.
I know that you are throwing your life away.
That may be. It's my choice. If only... If only I could hear his voice once more. If we could laugh together as we did as children.
Hey, wake up.
What happened?
No.
Are you alright?
Yeah. I saw the Glacian. It's okay. She's gone now. You guys check out our drivers.
Got it. You good?
Yes, I'm fine. Let's go.
Okay.
Luna.
You too. I'm sorry. I couldn't be there for you.
I feel I've earned the right to call you Nott. For a moment I felt death's chill wind, such is the might of the gods. But then I remembered I'm immortal. Such is my blessing and curse. Your attack hurt me, nevertheless. My feelings, at least. And after all the memories we've shared, remember this. Ah, I should have asked if you remember him. Truly a blast from the past. Nay. You mustn't take what's not yours.
Where is he?
He? The little gunman's a short shot away.
Where?
Where else but Gralia, the seat of the Empire? I'm sure he'll be delighted to see you. And you might even find your crystal. With all these demons about, you could certainly use it. Off you go, then. I wouldn't want to keep you from your friend.
We should be drawing close to Gralia.
Yeah.
I can't imagine what it'll be like.
Swarming with demons, but you knew that.
Huh. Don't remind me.
Once we arrive, we'll make for the Keep.
The Keep?
Zagnortus, an Imperial megafortress said to be impregnable.
With Prompto and the crystal inside it.
What goes in must come out. So, are we buying the story that the crystal can purge demons?
The proof is in the purging, but it does stand to reason. We've observed that as the nights have grown longer, the demon hordes have grown stronger. If they are in fact averse to the crystal's light, it could save not only Lucis, but the world.
We'll find out once we take it back.
The hell?
What is it?
My guess, something to sidetrack us. What now?
Whoa!
Go run! Don't worry about us!
Let's get to work.
What's wrong?
The weapons.
We're stuck. Get back!
Run!
Come on, move it!
Only a matter of time before we run out of room to run.
Got a better idea?
We trade the train for the Regalia.
Come on!
On my way!
Locked! The freight car!
Keep moving!
Strap in.
Yeah. Got it.
Ah!
closing. For it!
Come on, old girl.
That's all she's got.
It'll do. Dad, thanks for everything.
Are we seriously marching into the capital empty-handed?
And with no assurances, the crystal can beat back the demon hordes.
Guess we'll find out the hard way. No turning back now, right? This thing could come down at any time.
Let's be quick. Come on, this way.
Hey! Ignis! Gladio!
Look at you, all by lonesome.
You again. You know, for an Imperial Chancellor, you were one sick son of a bitch. Demons, the hell do you want? Leave me alone! This is getting out of hand. Connected below. Might be my ticket to the top.
Does it feel to be powerless? Can't help your friends if you can't help yourself.
Gotta hurry and find them.
wherever they are.
Can't you simply taste the air of foreboding?
Another trick. Back to square one.
Security clearance raised to level 3. Access to level 3. Zones authorized.
Oh, you should have seen the look on your face. You'd best hurry. Next time, it might really be your friend. That's one of my personal favorites. Are you certain it wasn't the real thing? Wouldn't want to make a mistake. Your heart's desire, so close now. Soon it will be within your grasp. I suggest you take the central elevator. The higher you climb, the further you fall. Can't you simply taste the air of foreboding? Did you hear that? There's something out there.
What's this smoke? Where's it coming from?
Aha! Well, you can't say I didn't warn you.
Thicker by the second. Need to stop it. Oh, it's clearing. That was close.
Once upon a time, they were children of nature, beasts and men. Oh, and you've killed so many. The infantry units you callously dubbed MTs all began as maids in this very facility. Imprinted with serial codes and incubated until they were strong enough to fight. What a pity. Innocent souls fated to suffer at the hands of a foreign king. Well, not so empty after all, are they? Fascinating tidbit about your dear Prompto.
What?
Turns out he's not empty either. He's got quite the skeleton in his closet.
This place. What are they keeping inside? Not sure what that is, but I got a hunch it's bad. Don't like it one bit. Wasn't expecting that. Things are looking up.
How will this story end, I wonder?
Intruder alert. Mobilizing dormant Magitek infantry.
What the?
Wait. Is that what's waiting inside?
In case there was any doubt, it's a trap.
Didn't see that coming.
A little pain never hurt anyone. On you go. Hurry. While you dawdle, people are dying.
Done it now.
No. Get here. Hey. Ah! No. Yeah. Yeah.
Claudio.
Where are you?
Yeah.
Nox in trouble.
Got him. There ought to be a kill switch nearby. Find it.
Well, how do you know that?
I believe it's the reason we were brought here.
Yeah. Hey.
That was close.
How the hell did you get here?
You're welcome.
Thanks.
After we were separated, we received help. From the usual suspect.
That bastard's playing with us. But at least we're together.
All but one of us.
Reunited with your retainers at last. How very touching. Must be a fine feeling, having friends. Look how happy you are. I pray you find your dear Prompto soon.
Hey, you all right?
Are you hurt? Do you need help?
I'm fine. Thank you, Noct.
No sweat.
Tell me, were you worried about me?
Of course I was. What kind of question is that?
Of course. That's why you came. Like I believed you would.
Prompto.
That's why I told myself I couldn't die. Not until I could see you, and hear you tell me I'm not a fake, that I'm the real me.
I'm sorry.
Don't be. Everything's all right now.
Knocked. Did you hear that?
Hear what?
I've heard this sound before. On the train, just before your weapons failed you. It's nearby. And it may hold the key to restoring your power.
It's here. This thing?
Door's locked.
It's coming from within. Is there no way through?
There's a way. So, MTs, they've got those code prints. Just like I do.
Do they? Never looked.
Yeah. So, as it turns out, I'm one of them. Not exactly something I could tell people growing up in Lucis. Still, you guys are like the only friends I've ever known. I just hope that things can stay the way they were.
Whatever. Who cares where you were born? I don't see you turning against us. Not now or ever.
Thanks, guys. Still, I can't change where I came from. What I am.
Since when does where you come from matter to you?
Hmm?
You never once treated me as a prince.
It's got you there.
Never so much as a highness.
We're done here. Come on, crown citizen.
You're one of us, right?
Unless you'd rather not be.
Did it work?
With the device down and out, Nox power should be up and running.
Go on, try it.
All right. Moment of truth.
Oh!
We're back, baby.
Good game.
What a relief. Let's roll.
You again, new friend? I see you decided to rock the...
Had to. No weapons, no friends, no choice, really. You know, somebody here's got to fight to rescue the crystal. Not to mention rescue all of your asses.
Spoken like a true king. About time.
That's
a great vibe.
Dead meat!
Don't suffer!
You can say that again. Especially now that you don't have your weapons.
Hey!
Hurry up. Ain't got time to waste.
Think I don't know that?
Hopefully Biggs and Wedge both made it to safety.
Who and who?
Our train drivers.
And soldiers. They can fend for themselves.
One hell of a hangar.
Look at all this space.
So, the central elevator's through here.
And out of the loading bay.
Your Majesty, your precious crystal awaits you. To liven things up, I thought I'd take you on a stroll down memory lane. Of course, memories decay with time.
What's left of him?
Damn it.
Sorry end for the High Commander. For anyone. He was a man with hopes and dreams.
Ugh. It's horrible.
What kind of fiend makes demons of men?
Look alive! Company!
We're getting nowhere!
And they just keep coming!
No! Let's go on our own! What? If you can obtain the crystal's power, you may yet be able to tell the target. Elsewise, we are all like to perish here.
Biggie's right. It's our only chance.
What about you?
You'll manage somehow! Just get moving!
You could still get to the crystal if you went on your own. Your friends will have to stay behind.
Hangar gate closing. Please stand clear.
You better think fast. I don't envy you your decision.
So, this is the way to the crystal.
Betraying your friends for the greater good. The mark of a monarch. Step forth, your majesty.
Closed.
Don't die on me.
Do you suppose your dear friends are still alive? Those who died for you, do you ever wonder what went through their minds? Can you even recall their final words?
I'll come back for you all. I swear. How far does this go? The crystal had better be here. Everyone's counting on it. Counting on me.
Your journey is over, Noct.
help me stop the demons.
Unharmed by the light, the chosen king can do. Allow me to regale you with a tale. In an age long past, an incurable scourge ravaged mankind. A tiny menace that twisted men into monsters, the likes of which you've seen. In Lucis lived a savior who could cure the afflicted. His body would come to host myriad demons, countless lives be spared. But a jealous king, one chosen by the crystal, ostracized and demonized this healer of the people, making a true monster of him. I gave you my name earlier, but you should know that it was not a name given to me at birth. Arden Lucis Kylum is my proper name. You'll never guess whose name is in here. Killing this mortal will bring me satisfaction. Playing my crystal's power, arise as its champion. Only once the crystal and the king are no more. I know redemption. Come back soon. I shall keep your friends coming to you.
Strength, O Chosen. This world falls to the King of Kings. His providence consecrated in the divine light of the crystal. So it is ordained, the revelation of Bahamut. The soul of the star. And it is in this place that the king will gain the power to fulfill his calling. They stand against the darkness and abide in hope. Sustained by faith unfaltering that their king shall arise and bring deliverance. By the covenants awakened, the six have seen the coming of the prophesied hour. A time when the crystal shall have shed the entirety of its light unto the ring. Only then, once the sacred ring is replete, can the true king complete his ascension? And only by the true king's hand can the immortal accursed be banished and the light restored to this world. one cursed with life eternal, whose immortality stems from the selfsame scourge that wrought the demons. One so impure of body and soul was deemed unworthy of the crystal's light and forbidden to ascend. His mind twisted by spite and bent on revenge, the usurper came to bring darkness down upon our world. Only the true king, chosen by the crystal and guarded by his forebears, can end the accursed's madness. It is the sole means to ending the immortal accursed. A power greater than even that of the Six, purifying all by the light of the crystal and the glaives of rulers past. Only at the throne can the Chosen receive it, and only at the cost of a life his own. The King of Kings shall be granted the power to banish the darkness, but the blood price must be paid. To cast out the usurper and usher in Dawn's light will cost the life of the Chosen. Many sacrificed all for the King, so must the King sacrifice himself for all. Now enter into reflection, let the light of Providence shine within. Is full. Go forth to the kingdom where the usurper awaits. Reclaim the throne and fulfill the calling of the true king.
Be waiting. And Hammerhead. Demons everywhere.
Ready for this? Yeah?
It's me, Talcott. My grandpa served the Amasidia family.
Talcott?
Yeah.
No way.
Yes way. Welcome back, Your Majesty. Yes, sir. That's right. Huh? Just a second. Said he wants to have a word with you.
He can have it in person.
He said you can have it in person. Okay. We should be there shortly, sir. Wow. I can't tell you how good it is to see you again.
Yeah, you sure look different, though.
You think so? Guess I've grown some these 10 years.
10 years?
The guys must be pinching themselves right now.
Where are they, anyway?
Listalem, more often than not, but they take a lot of trips to Hammerhead.
For?
For Miss Cindy. You know, back at the garage. She's a tough one, but when she needs a little extra muscle out on the road, she gives them a call.
Huh.
Oh, speaking of which, the guys said they're near Hammerhead right now, so we'll be meeting them there. You know, ever since you disappeared, Your Majesty, it's been nothing but nighttime, nonstop. Listalem still has light, thanks to the power plant, so just about everyone's taken refuge there.
Only there?
Everywhere else has been abandoned. Demons moved in, forcing the people to move out. People still swing by the garage at Hammerhead from time to time, but it usually isn't for repairs. These days it's less of a service station and more of a slayer station, a base for demon hunting. The garage is still open, though. One of the few places that is.
So, Sid, he's still alive and kicking?
He's kicking all right, just not as hard as before. He hasn't really been himself lately. At least, not since he moved out to Listalem. Someone suggested he move the garage there too, but old man Sid wasn't having it. He called it a big fat chocobo turd of an idea. Said it just wouldn't be the same anywhere else.
That sounds like Sid, all right.
Miss Cindy said she didn't mind either way, so the garage will probably stay put for a while. And without any tinkering to do, Ignis's gourmet seafood is about all Sid has left to look forward to. With all the demons prowling around, more folk were getting hurt. Or worse. So Iris talked the Marshal into taking out the demons themselves. Iris the Demon Slayer, they call her. Gladio and the others, they lend him a hand whenever they can. Prompto spends most of his time hunting around Hammerhead. He tries to impress Miss Cindy, but she's already married to her work.
And Ignis?
He hunts too. We tried to stop him, but he wouldn't listen. He said if anything, he's more used to the darkness than we are.
Never got his vision back.
I'm afraid not. But that being said, he gets by pretty well on his own. Gladio and Prompto usually hunt on their own as well. It isn't often you see the three of them together nowadays. They still work as a team every once in a while, but each has his own set of tasks to keep him busy.
Is that so?
We've arrived, Your Majesty. Everyone will be so happy to see you. Don't worry. I won't be going anywhere. If you have any other questions, please don't hesitate to ask.
That's all you have to say for yourself after all this time?
Knocked! It's you! It's really you!
I hadn't realized.
Well, well. You kept us waiting.
Not like I wanted to. We've got catching up to do.
Let's head inside.
So, Ignis, you're really cooking like you used to.
More or less. I can manage with far less help than I required before.
You know, it's okay to ask for help. You don't need to prove anything to us.
Probably more about proving it to himself. I say we leave him to it.
Yeah, I guess that's how he got so good. Even better than before, if you can believe it.
My taste buds sure do.
Perhaps I've developed a culinary sixth sense.
Hey, Iggy, you ought to follow Wescombe's example. Open up a restaurant.
I'll give the matter some thought. Assuming such demand still exists in a post-apocalyptic world.
I'm more than happy to tell you everything I know. We've even got some former Imperials fighting for us. The toughest of them said she used to lead a band of mercenaries.
Aranea?
So you do know her. Well, I'm not surprised. The Marshal said she was feared far and wide back in the day. But now she's revered among the Lucian masses. Same with her men, Biggs and Wedge. Each of them leads their own small army.
That's great.
I'm more than happy to tell you everything I know. We've even got some former Imperials fighting for us. The toughest of them said she used to lead a band of mercenaries.
Aranea?
So you do know her. Well, I'm not surprised. The Marshal said she was feared far and wide back in the day. But now she's revered among the Lucian masses. Same with her men, Biggs and Wedge. Each of them leads their own small army.
That's great.
I'm more than happy to tell you everything I know. Oh, right. About the Empire.
Huh.
Gladio brought back word that both the Emperor and High Commander were dead. With those two gone, Niflheim pretty much fell apart.
Yeah, figured.
I'm more than happy to tell you everything I know. The Chancellor's still around, though. In Insomnia. Nobody who saw him had any clue what he might have been up to. But their stories piqued Ignis's curiosity. I ended up helping Ignis look into the matter, digging through old records, even joining him on trips to the royal tombs.
Royally roped into it.
It's cool. I'm a bit of a history buff myself. But we did discover something pretty weird.
Huh?
While we were poring over all those ancient texts, one name caught our eye. Ardens. Apparently he was hailed as a savior, healing all those who were ravaged by demons, only to end up branded a demon himself. A dubious charge, I'd say. By all accounts, he was just as human as you and me.
Huh.
I'm more than happy to tell you everything I know. On the bright side, we've come a little closer to understanding the demons.
And?
You see, I'd always thought they were animals, only more hideous and savage. But it turns out they're just ordinary people. Unlucky folk infected by something or other that transformed them into monsters. There's no known cure as of yet. So death is the only mercy. I'm more than happy to tell you everything I know. We've got a lot of survivors pouring in from Accordo, too. What with all the demon attacks there as of late? Not like it's much better here. Lestalem's practically overflowing with refugees from Insomnia. The Empire's recovery assistance fell by the wayside, and demons overran the city. Thankfully, Iris and the Marshal managed to evacuate the civilians. Now there's no one left, except the demons. I spent my childhood in the Crown City. It's sad knowing it's gone, you know?
Not for long. I became the king to reclaim our home, and now I'm back, as promised.
All these years and you remembered.
You bet.
I'm more than happy to tell you everything I know. Your Majesty? Do you remember my grandfather?
Yeah.
There's something I wasn't able to tell you back then. Grandpa died because of me. It was my fault. An Imperial officer approached me in town, asked if I was from the Crown City, and that was just the beginning.
What brings you here, young man? You didn't come here by yourself, did you? Oh, your grandfather's a butler at a manor. How very grand. Oh, he rubs shoulders with the royal family. You must be ever so proud.
I answered him without thinking. A little after that, the man showed up at our hotel.
Talcott.
Think what you will of me, but please know that Grandpa didn't give you away.
Listen.
Yeah?
You're not a kid anymore. You should know by now what happened that day wasn't your fault. None of it. You know, it's hard to ask someone about their pain, but it's just as hard to share your own with someone else. I appreciate you opening up to me, and I swear I'll make things right. But believe me when I say nobody blames you. Not me, not your grandpa. Trust me, you have the king's word.
I suppose you're right, Your Majesty. Thank you. Safe travels, Your Majesty.
Well, fellas, we're homeward bound at last. Time to suit up.
Finally get to rock these threads.
Wear them with pride.
Yeah. Just hope they still fit.
Home sweet home.
Yeah. At long last.
What we've been waiting for.
Sure is.
Next stop, the Citadel.
Yeah.
This is it. Give it your all, guys.
Yeah.
You got it!
With pleasure. Ah!
Fought together like this in ages.
Really takes it back, doesn't it?
We may have struggled before, but now nothing can stand in our way. I'm sensing a powerful aura. Intimator! Let's take it down.
Ignis, I need you to...
But of course!
Might be slowing my legs down.
Fight through it. Can't make it without you.
Ah, yes, sir, Your Majesty.
I sense trouble.
You sense right. Nice, Iggy!
No time for compliments.
Yeah, we got work to do.
Ready for this?
Oh, here we are.
Ha!
Impeccable.
Ifrit, the Infernian. He doesn't share the Glacians' fondness for mankind. But you can expect a warm welcome. I shall await you above.
Stay cool. He's gonna bring the heat.
Hang in there, buddy! Stay down! We'll keep him busy!
Knox, over here! Quickly, before he strikes again!
Here it comes! I got your back!
Here you go. Let's go!
What did she say?
Told me to bring back the light.
That's our next stop.
On we go.
At long last, the Citadel.
The throne is just up ahead.
It's all lit up.
Guess he's expecting company.
He wants this as bad as we do.
Think the elevator's working?
Huh. Sure looks like it.
He is really taking us by the hand.
He'll save our legs the walk up.
The throne room waits outside.
Yeah. And so does Arden.
Acting like he owns the place.
It's time to take it all back.
It ends here. Tonight.
Remember how nervous we were in front of King Regis the day we left?
That was the last time we were in here.
Yeah, they even let me in that day.
Feels like forever ago.
Not much farther.
Well, shall we, Noct?
Yeah, but... hold on a sec. Prompto, can I see your photos?
Yeah.
I just need one. To take with me.
Yeah. I get it. You can take whichever you like. Then it's settled. That's the one? No backsies?
Yeah.
What is that?
I'm afraid you're out of luck. The throne brings you here. It seats only one.
Off my chair, Jester. The king sits there.
Oh, Noct. How I have waited for this. Longer than you could ever know. Tonight, the dreams of the Blood Royal come to an end.
Spite's all that's kept him going.
Talk about a grudge.
Arden sits the throne. Not for long. This is my ascension. What did you do?
They have no place in this. The Battle of Kings. Come, Noctis.
It ends now.
The once helpless and hapless prince. Is he now ready to claim his crown? Don't
let us down. Let the games begin.
No. Now they end.
So you are the chosen king. But you are a second choice at best. Must I wait? The legend proved to be a myth. Disappointing! Now it is over, Majesty. What will you do? Banish the demons and bring peace? Erase me from history once more?
This time, you can rest in peace. Close your eyes. Forevermore.
I will await you in the beyond.
So this is farewell.
Yeah. Here we are.
It's all you.
No turning back now.
Prompto. Gladio. Bigness. I leave it to you. Walk tall, my friends.
Godspeed. take care. Majesty.
I'm home. I walk tall. And though it took me a while, I'm ready now. I love you all. Luna. Guys. Dad. Time we had together, I cherish. Kings of Lucis. Come to me!
can it. Ready? Steady.
Really?
Push!
Something so heavy.
Unbelievable.
Not exactly a fairy tale beginning, huh, Prince Noctis?
We let ourselves get carried away.
Look, these things happen.
Let's just hope this isn't some omen.
Gladio, do me a favor.
What?
Push this thing by yourself.
All by myself?
You won't even notice if we just let go.
Prompto, don't even think about it.
Save some breath for pushing.
Ignis, come on, time to switch.
Nuh-uh, we just switched back there.
And...
the four of us around a campfire. How long's it been?
An eternity.
So yeah.
Out with it.
I just... Damn it. Why the hell is this so hard? So I've made my peace. Still, knowing this is it, and seeing you here now, it's more than I can take.
Yeah, you're damn right it is.
Huh, you spit it out.
That's good to hear.
Well? What can I say? You guys are the best.
Thank you.
dearest Luna. You did well to deliver the ring to Noctis. Wayward, though my son may indeed be, he has made me proud. May you too know happiness.
Thank you.